Hello, and welcome to this bite-sized edition of TDO. Like many of you, I'm staying home as instructed, while healthcare workers, like my wife, fight a gallant battle against an invisible enemy. Thankfully, I can work from home. And when I'm not doing that, I hope to produce videos that give you a slice of normality during these testing times. In the last episode, all these old capacitors were removed from a couple of Amiga 2000 power supplies, and they are just over 30 years old. I have some knowledge of how capacitors work, and that these electrolytic capacitors usually leak and dry up over time. But I'm sat here wondering, what do they look like inside? The largest is this 680 microfarad capacitor. The outer case is made of a heat shrink plastic that both adds electrical insulation and a convenient means to show specification and manufacturer's logo. A cut with a sharp knife down one side, allows it to be peeled away, revealing a shiny aluminium can. On the top, we can see where the case has been weakened, the lines being where the metal is thinner. If pressure builds up inside this sealed can, this is where it should burst from in a more controlled manner. On the bottom are the two terminal leads, which go through a rubber seal. The aluminium is soft, and a small pair of wire cutters is all I need to remove the case crimp. Pulling on a terminal lead reveals another cylinder. There's a subtle smell. Slightly chemical, slightly fishy. Not nice, but equally not displeasant. There is tape across a join. Once cut, I can unfurl this surprisingly long sandwich of materials. The brown layers are a paper impregnated with the electrolyte liquid. It is believed that an incomplete, stolen formula for electrolyte caused the capacitor plague of the early 2000s. It corroded the aluminium, creating a gas that caused them to burst. These predate that time and are from a reputable manufacturer, and I see no evidence of corrosion. Next is the aluminium anode foil, with an aluminium oxide layer as a dielectric. The surface is etched to increase surface area, and feels like a 1200 grit sandpaper to the touch. And finally, we have the shiny aluminium cathode foil. And are smaller capacitors any different? In short, no. Just less surface area to store a smaller charge. Well, I hope you enjoyed this quick look inside 30-year-old capacitors and found their construction as fascinating as I did. Well, I'm off to go wash these gloves so I can reuse them again. Until next time, goodbye, and stay safe indoors.
Let me see your identification. We don't need to see his identification. Follow me. Move along.